Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today I'm going to show you how to have automatically numbered chapters in a table of contents in Pages. MacMost is supported by more than 600 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So it's fairly easy to create a table of content in Pages. And when you do, you can easily add and remove chapter titles as needed. But if you also want to have those chapters numbered, most people just manually number them. But this could be a problem if you have a bunch of chapters and you suddenly want to insert one in the middle. Then you have to renumber all the chapters after that. However, there is a technique you can use to have the chapters automatically numbered. This way, inserting a new one is no problem. So here I have an example book. It's just a bunch of chapter titles and a few paragraphs in between each one. Now the idea is I want to create a table of contents with all of these chapter titles and I want them to be numbered. So creating the table of contents is pretty easy. I'm going to put the cursor here at the beginning. I'm going to do Insert Table of Contents for the entire document. Now that creates a page here at the start with my table of contents and you can see each heading is there. The reason these lines were chosen for the table of contents is if I look in the text and I select one of these lines, you can see it's set to heading style. Each one of these is heading style. Then if I go to table of contents and I select that, I can click on table contents on the right sidebar, look at customize styles, and see that the heading style is the one being used to create the table of contents. Now the goal is to have these numbered 1, 2, 3, etc. But not just to have them numbered, but to allow me to insert one in the middle and it will automatically renumber everything. After all, I could simply go and put one period at the beginning here, and if I look here, I can see that there. But by manually numbering them, I'm in trouble if, say, I insert a chapter in the middle and then I have to go and renumber all the chapters after that. Now, when you think of numbering, you should be thinking of numbered lists, which is exactly what we're going to be using here. So I'm going to go here in the format sidebar and go all the way to the bottom and there's bullets and list. I'm going to expand on that and I'm going to change the bullets from no bullets to numbers. Since I only have that one line selected, that's where my cursor is, it just changes that one line. And you can see it's set to numbers. I can set the type of numbers. So I can do Roman numerals or something like that if I want. I'm just going to stick with the standard numbers here. And it's just this one item numbered number one. Now if I were to do that for each one of these, it would just number each one a number one since it's not a continuous list. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click here for the bullets and list styles. And what I'm going to do is create a new one. I'm going to hit the plus button here and I'm going to call this one chapter numbers. I'm also going to assign a keyboard shortcut to it. Clicking here, I can assign the shortcut F1 to it. So now I can go down to the next heading here, select that. When I press F1, you can see that also becomes the chapter numbers style for bullets and lists. But that one starts at 1 as well. However, if I look down here, you can see I can choose start from and a number or continue from previous. If I select continue from previous, it will pick up the count from the last time that style was used. So I get number 2. So if I go down to here, I do F1 and then I select continue from previous. And you can see that's number 3. And I'll just do that for each one of those. And now I have all the chapters numbered 1 through 7. If I look at the table of contents, those numbers carry on into the table of contents there. Now that might seem like a little bit of work to do it for each chapter, but if you start off doing that at the beginning, then it's no problem. For instance, I can add a new chapter here, and all I need to do is change that to the heading style, hit F1, and then select continue from previous. Now this works with copy and paste, so if I copied this chapter title here and pasted it, you could see not only did it pick up the heading style and the bullets and list chapter number style, but it also picked up continue from previous, making it even easier. Now the cool thing is if I decide to add a chapter in the middle, like maybe right here, it'll automatically renumber things. So here's the name of the chapter. I'll make it a heading and I will hit F1 to make that a chapter numbered bullets and list style. And then I'll click on continue from previous. And you can see now all of the chapter numbers after it have been pushed down by 1. Now another advantage of doing it this way is I can change the style really easily. Since these are all set to the chapter number style, I can update it. Let me take this first one here and I will change it from this type of numbering to using Roman numerals. I can then go to the styles here and hit the update button, and you can see they all update now to using Roman numerals. And I can look here at the table of contents and see that's all been updated there as well. Now there are some limits to this technique. Most notably, you can't have a custom numbering scheme. So for instance, if you wanted to say have chapter space 1 colon and the name of the chapter, you can't do that. The number's got to be first and you have to use the period or a right parenthesis after the number. It also would be nice to have a way just to have chapter names like chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, and not have to have titles for each one. You can do that with this technique now and using just a blank line, making that numbered, and then you can have just like the number 1 followed by a period. But in most cases you want the number by itself or you want the word chapter before it. In that case you still have to do everything manually. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.